Parker is 29 and learning to communicate again. The students teaching him earn a degree with 100% job placement. But the real reward is changing a life. At Alabama A&M, it's a university where agencies actually go to recruit compassionate students who help themselves by helping others. Service is sovereignty at Alabama A&M University. Start here, go anywhere.
Companies hunger for our food scientists. Here, a new generation manages our cities of tomorrow. The discovery of hardier plants, healthier animals, is growing at our research station, Alabama A&M University, where new designs and ideas are put to the test. Be a researcher in our labs, or a forestry fire dog in our fields. Alabama A&M University. Start here, go anywhere.
Ariel took down enough pens to help win a conference championship. Her mechanics are just as strong in engineering. Aiden is mastering psychology on the golf course and in the classroom. No hurdles too high for Raven, on the track or in nutrition. Alabama A&M, 4 years of artistic, academic, and athletic discovery. We deliver the full university experience. Alabama A&M University. Start here. Go anywhere.
Daryl brings new energy to the power plant. Julian's accounting is by the numbers. They're student interns from the College of Business and Public Affairs at Alabama A&M University, where marketing class connects with the community and companies come to recruit. So while Kyle strengthens his managerial skills, he's earning a business degree and experience at Alabama A&M University. Start here, go anywhere.
Hello, I'm Dwayne Green, Interim Director of the Office of Admissions. We're excited that you are here with us today, and because you are here, we know that each of you had other options, but you chose Alabama A&M to be your number one choice. For the next 3.5 minutes, this video will illustrate to you the journey of how we got here. It will also introduce to you our hardworking team and the roles they played over the last 10 months in getting you here today. Welcome to Alabama Agricultural and Mechanical University, and we hope you will enjoy.
I bet you won't beat the largest HBCU in the state of Alabama. I bet you won't beat the HBCU with the best STEM program in the nation.
Let's talk about this classic record. Four ties, 34 wins by AS who? AS somebody. 39 win Bulldogs. I bet you won't catch up.
I bet you won't. 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 I bet you won't.
I bet you won't beat the Million Dollar Man. Go Bulldogs.
I bet you won't. 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 I bet you won't.
Team, I bet you won't. I bet you won't. I bet you won't. Not this classic. You heard me?
I bet you won't. 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 I bet you won't.
Green, Interim Director of the Office of Admissions. We're excited that you are here with us today, and because you are here, we know that each of you had other options, but you chose Alabama A&M to be your number one choice. For the next 3.5 minutes, this video will illustrate to you the journey of how we got here. It will also introduce to you our hardworking team and the roles they played over the last 10 months in getting you here today. Welcome to Alabama Agricultural and Mechanical University, and we hope you will enjoy.
somebody. 39 win Bulldog. I bet you won't catch up.
I bet you won't. 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 I bet you won't.
I bet you won't beat the Million Dollar Man. Go Bulldogs.
Team, I bet you won't. I bet you won't. I bet you won't. Not this classic. You heard me?
I bet you won't. I bet you won't.
soccer, something like that. That.
Station sometimes.
Why?
And ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another edition of Alabama A&M Basketball. I'm Reginald Reese alongside Josh Spurler live from downtown Huntsville, Alabama. How you doing?
I'm doing all right, Reggie. I'm just excited to see the start of a new Alabama A&M basketball season. You know, I'm looking forward to what they got to approve this season, man.
Well, you know, this year, right now, A&M's coming into this game 0-6. We have a matchup of SWAC versus Conference USA basketball and D1 play. A&M's coming to this game 0-6, like I said before, but UAB's coming in 4-2. They're trying to avenge a big-time defeat at the hands of Florida State in the Advocate Invitational, whereas A&M's trying to get their first win on the season. So pretty young season, pretty big game for both squads.
Yeah, you said it. You said it right, Red. Well, I'm looking forward to see how A&M is going to play the defense against the Blazers tonight. Because, you know,
Well, UAB, they're actually ranked in the top 50 in defense. They defend the three-point line really well. 29% from the three-point line that they give up. That's amazing defensive perimeter basketball. They're no joke, and they're led by their current three-year head coach, Robert Eschen, 41-31 overall record. But what do you think A&M can do to slow down the defensive style of UAB?
Well, they have to spread the floor, you know, try to get the ball on the inside because, you know, UAB, they have they like in the top 25 in the three-point contest. They in the top 25 on the three-point, containing the three-points. But I think A&M should watch out for Zach Bryan tonight because last game he had 26 points.
Well, you're right about that. Zach Bryan averaging 14 points per game, leading the team right now in scoring. But on the other side of that, you have Arthur Johnson averaging about 12 points per game himself, returning from last year's squad. But do you think this A&M team is trying to fire themselves, especially after head coach Donnie Marsh from last year leaving?
Well, I see they found them. Like last season, they didn't have a big man, you know, a reliable big man. So now they have they have a big man, you know. So I'm looking forward to see what they got to prove this season.
Well, you know, this year so far, they're 0-6. Just right now, still no SWAC competition. But they're kind of short. Their tallest player is 6'9", and that's Shaquille Seville, the transfer out of East Florida State University. And outside of that, they have 6'7", 6'6", and 6'5" players all around, so they're really playing a lot of small ball. But so is UAB.
Well, UAB got 2 6'10" players on their team, so it's going to be tough down low in the paint for the Alabama A&M Bulldogs.
You know, I think UAB, what's going to hurt them will probably be the inside defense. Like you say, when you have 2 6'10" players playing in the low post, they can score at will. But small ball has proven to be a thing in the modern game of basketball, so that might be the difference maker tonight.
Yeah, you said that right, Jalen. So what I think A&M could do is try to sell a lot of picks, you know, move around, try to get their big mans out the paint, and try to do an isolation game, sit them one-on-one, you know, and take the ball to the hoop.
I think A&M should take to try and see just how good this UAB perimeter defense is. Because, you know, if they're playing good perimeter defense, it starts at the guard positions. And when UAB is only giving up 29% from three, maybe head coach Dylan Howard might try to test it real early to see just how good it actually is.
Yeah, you're right. You're right, Red. Because, I mean, they could, you know, create shots by sending a lot of picks, you know, doing like a Steph Curry style, you know, running around. But, you know, Jalen Reed came off last season. He was a good three-pointer shooter. So I'm looking forward to him hit, knock down a couple threes tonight.
UAB starting lineups being called off right now. So
great basketball, of course, starts with great coaching. For Alabama A&M, they've had an influx of coaches come through. Recently, Donnie Marshall's only there for 2 years. He left this past summer. Now you have Dylan Howard, named the interim head coach. But do you think A&M is trying to find a brand new identity of itself with all the new faces coming in and out the program?
I mean, yeah, but you know, it's based on the recruiting status, you know. So we have to recruit, go around and recruit great players from great schools. You know, we invest more in the recruiting status.
I got you. But on the other side of that, you have UAB's head coach, Robert Eschen, 3-year head coach, 41-31 overall. He was the former assistant under Jared Haas from 2012 to 2016 for the Blazers. Do you think UAB can come in and maintain that defensive traditional style that Robert Eschen has put in place?
Well, yeah, Reg, because, you know, the Blazers, they are very defensive up front. They're a very defensive front team. So I'm pretty sure they'll try to look and lock down the Alabama and the Bulldogs.
Do you think there's a chance that maybe UAB could overlook the competition and A&M could probably sneak in and get maybe a sneaky victory?
Nah, it's too early in the season, man. You know, they got a lot to prove this season. So they're going to come out strong and finish hard.
I got you. And we're just a few moments away from tip-off. Alabama A&M donning the all-white jerseys with the maroon trim. UAB wearing the gray jerseys with the gold trim.
So let's, A&M, they're sponsored by Nike this year.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's a part of a big deal with the swag.
Yeah. All athletics got the Nike brand now.
Yep, Nike, Under Armour, Adidas. The Nike schools, you have Alabama A&M. You have Alabama A&M. You have, I think, is it Alcorn? I think Alcorn State also. And for the Adidas schools, you have, oh, goodness.
You have Alabama State as an Adidas school. Alcorn also.
I'm sorry about that. Our Nike schools, you got A&M, Alcorn, Pine Bluff, and Jackson State, Adidas, Bama State, Grambling, and Prairie View, Under Armour, Southern, and Texas A&M. And we're live with the tip-off. Here we go. Bringing the ball up the court for Alabama A&M. You have number two. That's Brandon Miller moving the ball around. Driving down low and blocked at the rim, and that's that UAB defense coming into play, but A&M maintains the possession. Moving the ball around, top of the key. Pull up, jump shot, no good by number 10, Arthur Johnson, their leading points per game leader. And now UAB brings the ball up the floor. Moving the ball around, right wing. Over. Screen set. UAB trying to slow down the tempo, see if they can tire out A&M. And that's a bad shot put up. And another missed shot as Alabama A&M gets the rebound, bringing the ball up the floor. Number two, down low. And it's a foul called on UAB.
And yeah, Red, just like I said, they're going to have to box out down low, because they're very small down low, and UAB Blazers, they're very tall. They're a taller team than Alabama A&M.
Andre Kennedy got the gift of the foul on the last possession, and we got a jump ball situation. And the ref will give it in favor of Alabama A&M, it looks like. Oh, and they're going to switch it around. UAB got the possession on that jump ball. And inbounding is number five, Makar Gouye out of the Senegal.
You know where that's located?
Africa. And we got another foul call. We'll be with you the entire season for Alabama A&M, especially with SWAC basketball. me, Josh Bullard, as well as Jalen Herford, who will be around with us for another game, especially during SWAC time. The three-man crew will be back. And I think all three of us are really excited about that.
Back live next.
Three ball by number zero. That is Jalen Reeder. And you brought him up before, put up a lot, put up, I think, was it 26 points last game?
Well, yeah, like I said before the game started, they had to get Jalen Reeder open for the shots. And that was another three by the UAB Blazers. But Jalen Reeder, he's a great three-point shooter, so they had to find him on the three-point line.
Got to shake off the rust. Got to shake off the cobwebs. Coming out of retirement, you know.
Yeah.
And a near shot clock violation. As UAB makes another huge bucket. Now it's a 5-3 game. Here we go, moving the ball around. Reeder, passes to Candy. Reeder driving, doesn't get the foul and misses the layup, but number 22, Garrett Sism with the putback to make it a 5-5 game.
And Garrett Sism, he was the A&M leading scorer last game. He came out the game with 12 points. And he really, you know, put on the show last game.
Fast break chance after the big air ball missed three, but a huge block. The man out of Senegal with the huge defensive block. And that was Gouye, the sophomore, the 6'10 forward for the UAB Blazers. Here we go, moving the ball around. A&M with the possession. Reeder trying to get the offense working against this tough UAB defense. Johnson wanted to drive. He's still stuck at the right wing, but it's a turnover. And the fast break layup with the and one call goes for UAB. And that's now a 7-5 game.
Like you said before the game, Reg, the UAB Blazers, they're coming out strong with the 3-2 defense, and they playing nasty defense over the perimeter, and they limiting shots from three-point line. Excuse me.
Here we go, Lewis Sullivan at the line. And the and-one attempt is good. Here we go, A&M struggling. This UAB defense right now playing strong. And the double team works as UAB gets the ball right back, leading the game 8-5. UAB is one team foul against them. Here we go, Zach Bryant, their leading guard, bringing the ball up the floor. Back to Bell. Driving is number 21, Jalen Perry. And we have a timeout on the floor. And ladies and gentlemen, with that timeout, UAB still leads the game 8-5 with 15:57 to go in the first half. So do you think UAB right now, do you think their defensive style is working so far?
Well, everything you said before the game, it was true. You know, they playing good, great defense. You know, they locking down A&M, keeping them from getting open three-pointers, and you know, they're trapping down low, so it's very hard for them to score.
Well, right now, A&M, they're kind of struggling on offense a little bit, but not as bad as what we think.
I think they really have to draw fouls. If UAB is playing a lot of defense, you have to draw fouls. You have to get their star defensive players out of there. If you can't draw fouls and go to the free throw line, then UAB's defense is going to do what UAB expects it to do, and that's to lock you up and to keep you from scoring.
They actually got to do a better job moving the ball, you know, set screens, move around instead of they're doing a lot of staying still. They got to move around the court, you know, set screens, and allow the open man get open.
Well, here we go. We're coming out of the timeout. And let's see if A&M can make up for that last possession after the costly turnover. Once again, the score is 8-5 with 15:57 to go in the first half. And the inbound. Here we go, driving is number 23, Lewis Sullivan, and he will get the foul call as he goes to the free throw line. Lewis Sullivan right now shooting 78% from the free throw line, averaging 8.8 points per game.
No, he actually went to high school up here in Huntsville, Alabama.
Is that so?
Yeah.
Lewis Sullivan coming out of Hazel Green. I didn't know that. North Alabama native. Okay. And let's see what A&M can do. Down 11-5 after the free throws made by Sullivan. And out of bounds on A&M. And once again, that UAB defense coming to fruition. I tell you, I think A&M this year and for the last 3 years, they haven't had an identity like we talked about before. When you look at this A&M squad, I think it's really hard for them win this transition. It's a rebuild that I think they kind of just have to accept and sort of take gracefully and organically, as UAB with another transition score to make it a 15-5 game, and a timeout on the floor called for Alabama A&M and Dylan Howard. And we'll see what A&M will go over, and we'll see what interim coach Dylan Howard will do.
Reg, A&M, they're coming out. They're not passing the ball well, doing a lot of bad passes. They got to make sure they make a smart decision pass. Wait, get open, pass the ball, move the ball. See, they just doing bad passes right now.
Well, as we look at this Alabama A&M roster, a majority of the players, pretty much 13 of 15 players, all from Alabama. Brandon Houston, Walter Jones Jr., Evan Wiley, just to name three of the 13 from Alabama, Andre Kennedy and Jalen Reeder from Georgia and Florida. So Alabama really trying to maintain their pipeline here in the state, especially with the transfers that came in. For this Bulldog roster, they have five players returning. Those players are Brandon Houston, Evan Wiley, Brandon Wright, Arthur Johnson, and Andre Kennedy. But they also have 10 new faces. Some are freshmen, some are transfers. That's the missed three from A&M. It's no good. And number one, Zach Bryant misses the layup at the hole. Transition for A&M. Driving is number zero, Jalen Reeder. And he will get fouled. And Lewis Sullivan called for the foul. Just went to the free throw line, and now you give up a foul at the free throw line. And at the free throw line is number one, Andre Kennedy, the 6'7 forward out of Albany, Georgia. 205, one of the tallest players on the team. And the first free throw was no good. A&M as a team, they shoot just around 68% from the free throw line, so not a great free throw shooting team overall. Second free throw attempt is good, and that's now a 15-6 game, so they narrow the gap down to 9 points.
It's like A&M moving towards that man-to-man defense.
Well, they played a lot. They played a lot of man-to-man defense last year. As the steal for A&M, Reeder driving behind the back down low to Arthur Johnson, and he gets the foul. Plus one more at the free throw line. Arthur Johnson out of Marion, Alabama, averaging 12 points per game this year.
You know, Reds, after the timeout, you know, the coach talked to them. You know, they look like they're kind of pumped up right now.
Well, Dylan Howard, he's up on his feet right now. He looks really pumped up out of everybody else. The most pumped up. Sorry about that.
Arthur Johnson at the free throw. He averaged 11.2 points a game.
And Evan Wiley checks into the game for Alabama A&M. Coach Eschen trying to call some plays out for his UAB Blazer offense. Looking kind of frustrated on the sidelines, Coach. Relax yourself. Don't let the Bulldogs get to you now. Here we go. Let's see what UAB can do. Screen set. Moving the ball around. Once again, playing that slow tempo offense. Grit and grind. A&M almost had a turnover. The hop step back out. Three-point line. Wants the drive, thinking crossover. Step back, Jay, no good. A&M with the rebound. Bringing the ball up the court. Moving the ball around. Here we go, Trey Todd with the ball. Back over to Reeder. Walter Jones Jr. leading the team in three-point percentage at 40%, number 34. One of the new faces on this A&M team. Reeder, screen set from Sism. Sism, number 22, wants the drive. Gets the beautiful layup at the hole, and it's now a 15-11 game. Hold on, people. UAB hasn't run away with the lead just yet. A&M is still in it.
And the down-low game looks very better this year. Last year, was, you know, they had a lot to work with down-low because, you know, they had a 6'6", power four down-low. But now they have a 6'8". Power four down low this year.
Here we go, and the ball went out of bounds, called against UAB, so A&M will maintain possession. And number 32, Nolan Bertan, will check in for the UAB Blazers. So far, we're still early in the season. Conference play won't come until January. We have one more month of non-conference basketball left. Moving the ball around. Here we go, driving, in the low post, out, corner, three, no good for Reeder, and the rebound by Tavin Loven. And it's a beautiful interception, intercepted pass by number 22, Sism, to Reeder, but misses the finish at the hole on the fast break chance, and the ball will go out of bounds on A&M. Evan Wiley tried to avoid it, but he couldn't.
Well, Red, it looks to me that the UAB Blazers are having a tough time with Alabama A&M.
They seem to be kind of frustrated. They're playing good defense, but A&M is fighting through it, and that's what it's all about. You have to fight till the end. A&M, they're not going down without a fight.
And that's what I love about the Alabama A&M Bulldogs. They have great heart, you know. They have that drive to win no matter who they're going up against.
Ooh, beautiful crossover by the UAB guard. And it's down low and finished at the rim. As UAB now has a 19-11 lead. I believe that was number five, Maktar Gouye again. Here we go. Trey Todd with the basketball. Number three, one of the new faces as well. Top of the key, back over. Reeder driving, pull up, Jay, mid-range money for Jalen Reeder. And it's now a 19-13 game. Zach Bryant bringing the ball up the floor. Screen set. Crossover, back over. Left wing, top of the key. One to drive. Playing a lot of in and out basketball. Drives and kicks. UAB coming off of a 20-win season last year, going 20-13 overall. A&M coming off of a 2-28 campaign. The forced three is no good. Barely beat the shot clock, but no shot clock violation. Wiley with the basketball, but brings it back over to Trey Todd, the guard out of Phenix City, Alabama. Walter Jones Jr., one of the key shooters and three-point shot takers and makers for this Bulldog squad this year. The step back, Jay, he won't take it. Trey Todd, forced three, and barely gets it to go in, beating the shot clock and having the friendly roll. That was Trey Todd, the 5'11", 155-pound guard. Wow.
Yeah, Reg, they're doing better moving around, try to get open shots, and they're doing a great job with that right now.
Here we go. We'll be once again playing that slow-paced offense. Now the team really using the fast break tempo to their advantage, only using it unless necessary. As both teams are playing this slow, pacey basketball game, UAB now leading 21-16 after the low post layup. Here we go, Sism, down, number 34, Walter Jones Jr. Beautiful layup, beautiful finish. Timeout called on the floor by the Blazers, and the Blazers only have a three-point lead, 21-18, 9:43 to go in the first half.
No, Reg, it looks like this game gonna go down to the wire. Gonna be a close game.
And you saw the maroon and white marching band. We can hear them. Sorry about that. You can hear them. So, do you think our band has a chance to win? Maybe, you know, the Honda's Battle of the Bands Classic.
They always got a chance, man.
I think they finished tied for third last year.
Really?
I think so.
The fans are awesome. You know, they have an awesome director. Mr. Wright, he's an awesome director. You know, he's been here for how many years? Probably like five years. Probably longer than that. Well, since I've been here. He's been here since I've been here.
My mom, she actually performed under Wright back when he was at Fairfield High School in Birmingham, Alabama.
Wow.
So. I believe in our marching maroon and white. I think they can win it. Honda Battle of the Bands contest held every year in January. So be sure to show your support there.
You know, when they come, they perform and they show out.
Oh, yeah, they show out. And welcome back to the contest. UAB leads it 21-18. Their 10-point lead early on now erased to just three as A&M is fighting back and fighting hard.
Red, what do you see about the Alabama A&M, different about the Alabama A&M Bulldogs?
They're fighting. When you're in the state that you're in as a basketball program, all you can do is fight. The only thing you can do is fight. The only thing you can do is try to scrap and play tough basketball to win games. It doesn't matter what the scoreboard says at the end of the day. If you're a team that knows we came to fight and came to win, then that's what counts at this point in time. As UAB makes another layup to now make it a 23-18 game, we see some new faces on the floor for UAB, including number 11, Tamel Pearson, and number 32, Nolan Bertant. Johnson with the ball. Back to Miller, Brandon Miller, number 2 out of Harvest, Alabama. Wants to drive, but tough defense from Jeremiah Bell. Down low to Kennedy. The mid-range, he wanted the foul, thought he was touched. But the air ball will fall right into UAB's lap. Here we go. And the three from the corner, no good by Bertan. Fast break chance for A&M. Driving over. Three ball, money for Arthur Johnson. And it's now a 23-21 game. Here we go. UAB only has a 2-point lead.
No, Arthur Johnson, he's a great player. You know, I seen him in the gym every day working on his shot, trying to get his dribbling skill ready for the season. You know, he got a great heart, you know. He got great talent, too.
Right now, he's pretty much the de facto leader at this point, leading his team in a lot of categories, including assists per game as well as points per game. And Andre Kennedy as well, another leader for this team. He's a senior, just like Arthur Johnson, so they have to really carry this team on their backs this year, especially in SWAC competition. And it's another timeout on the floor. 7:42 to go in the first half. UAB leads it 23-21. So, as you see, our dance girls on the court right now, at center court. So I gotta ask you, besides the band, besides sport, what else do you like about A&M?
Well, A&M, there's a great school. You know, they have a great engineering program. You know, they help. You know, they helping the students out. You know, they have a good performance of Start Here, Go Anywhere. You know, they done a great job on the academic side as well.
We once again want to thank Alabama A&M for giving us A&M students the chance to broadcast the game and to commentate the game for you live here on YouTube. Alabama A&M, Start Here, Go Anywhere, and that's exactly what we do as A&M students. You start here and you can literally go anywhere. I have a friend of mine, he's being interviewed by Pixar for editing, so that's pretty huge.
No Start Here, Go Anywhere. A&M is the greatest HBCU to go to. People, it's the greatest.
We're the largest in the state, so.
Great. But you know, we live by that motto, Start Here, Go Anywhere.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Most definitely.
Come to A&M, you're going to come, you know, get your education.
We're in a growing department, especially in the communications program. Every year, continuously growing and building upon last year's success. And now let's get back to A&M basketball. Number one, Andre Kennedy at the free throw line. Senior, Albany, Georgia. And the 6'7 forward misses the free throw. Andre Kennedy right now, he's averaging well around 85% from the free throw line, so it's pretty weird for him to miss these free throws early on.
Reds, they got to hit these free throws because they can come in handy at the end of the game.
Always. You have to get points any chance you can get. Here we go, behind the back, and they're going to call a foul. And it's an offensive foul called against UAB.
Yeah, that was a bad push off by a UAB player.
Here we go. A&M with the ball one more time. And it's a foul called against A&M. I'm sorry, not a foul. He lost his handle, and the ball went out of bounds. And now inbounding for UAB is number 23, Lewis Sullivan. Oh, I'm sorry. It looks like Coach Eschen is going to go with a different person inbounding. That's number two, Jeremiah Bell, 6'1 guard out of Louisville, Kentucky. Bryant bringing the ball off the floor. Bryant has pretty much seen the most minutes out of anybody so far for UAB. And for A&M, it looks like Arthur Johnson and Andre Kennedy have seen the most minutes out of anybody on this squad. At the right wing, being locked down. Can't go anywhere. Screen set, goes off. Back to the left corner, driving. A lot of driving kicks, a three ball money for UAB. And that was made by number two, Jeremiah Bell. And UAB right now playing a lot of driving kick basketball, like I said before, and this time it does work on this possession. And UAB now has a 5-point lead.
No, Red. It seemed to me that A&M looked better on the defensive side this year than last year.
As number 20, Shaquille Seville misses. Oh. UAB in transition. Here we go. Bell with the ball. Screen set. Pull up. Jay. No good off the back iron. And it's a foul call. It's a push off. The foul is called on Shaquille Seville. And at the free throw line right now, number three, Tavin Lovin out of Franklin, Kentucky. Misses the first free throw. And Garon Sism subs back into the game for A&M at forward, the 6'8 junior out of Huntsville, Alabama. And the second free throw is no good, so UAB misses both free throws at the line. So A&M is doing its job on defense, but can they maintain the momentum on offense? Over to Kennedy. Back to Reeder. Here we go, moving the ball around. Screen set. Johnson crossover. Takes the screen. Over to Reeder. Wants to drive, but doesn't. Down low. Sism to Reeder. The jump shot, no good. The ball is saved by Sism. Over. Johnson, three ball, left wing, no good. Off of the backboard. And Bell with the rebound, driving the ball up the floor. Screen set over to Bryant. Bryant shooting under 30% from three-point this year. As it's a foul call, and that will send Tavin Lovin to the free throw line yet again. Let's see if he can make up for missing the two on the last trip. So A&M, we want to give out a congratulations to the Alabama A&M football team this year on a winning season. Congratulations to head coach Maynard, Connell Maynard, 6-5 this year. They went 5-2 in SWAC play, and we have five players named to the all-SWAC team for 2018. Congratulations to them.
Yeah, Rez, they had a phenomenal season. You know, they had great season, great classic. Everything was great. You know, they had a hard season this year. They get better each year, every year.
Almost definitely when you win the classic. I'm sorry, ASU, I had to do it to you. Well, it was a really good win. It was a really good win. Can't be mad at that. Pull up, Jay Johnson. No good. And UAB will get the ball. So once again, congratulations to the UAB Bulldogs football team. Big Magic City Classic victory. Winning season. Connell Maynard. Congratulations, coach.
Yeah, awesome season, you know. I'm looking forward to see what they gonna be next season.
I'm hearing whispers, maybe a SWAC championship appearance. Who knows?
Hopefully. Yeah.
Here we
go. They can do it.
I believe they can. They got a good team. Here we go. Right wing back over top of the key. Moving the ball around. Crossover. That's Bryant. The beautiful layup, no good. Bounces back iron, front iron, and out. But the foul will be called on A&M, and that's another foul called against the Bulldogs, it looks like.
During this little break, I want to congratulate the volleyball team, A&M volleyball team, becoming the runner-up in the volleyball championship.
And that's a missed. I'm sorry, that's a turnover by UAB. Back over. Jones Jr. Pull up. Jay. And doesn't bounce in. But there will be a foul called for A&M against number 23, Lewis Sullivan of UAB. That's Sullivan's first foul. 15 foul. Walter Jones Jr. inbounding the basketball. And once again, congratulations to the Alabama A&M volleyball women's team. What a year. 23-13, 17-1 in the SWAC. It doesn't get better than that. They fell to ASU in the SWAC championship, but it's okay. I believe they can win it next year. You had a great team this year. You can win it next year.
And all the players are young, so you know they can come back strong next year and actually win it next year.
As Jalen Reeder gets to the free throw line, trying to make one more in the and-one situation, 23-26, and the free throw is money. We have 4:36 to go in the first half. UAB leads it 26-24. And bringing the ball up the court is Jeremiah Bell, the senior guard out of Louisville, Kentucky, calling the play behind half court, brings it up the floor. To Goye, top of the key. Back to Bell. Calling for a screen. Over. And Slovin wanted the three but won't take it. Moving the ball around. Perry back. Corner three. Slovin no good. And A&M wins the possession in the hustle play. It was a scrap for the basketball, but A&M will win the possession. I'm sorry, UAB wins the possession. I apologize. They pointed A&M's direction, but they give it to UAB. Okay. Here we go. Slovin. Back over to Bell. Bell. Over three ball from the big man out of Senegal. No good as Tavin Slovin gets the putback. Brandon Miller with the ball now. Let's see if A&M can respond. Only down by four. Kennedy over Reeder. Three ball from the left wing. No good. Rebounded by number 12, Will Butler. To Jeremiah Bell. And the foul's called against A&M.
Reds, they have their A&M, they're getting great shots off, but they got to knock those shots down. You know, they getting open, they're doing better, moving around, trying to get open, but they have to knock them shots down.
Well, A&M, they're only down by 4 points right now, but you have to knock down those open shots if you want to actually take the lead in this game. And they haven't had the lead since they led 3-0 earlier on in the contest. Have to knock down shots consistently if you want to win ball games. Once again, the A&M March Maroon and White performing for you. Let's see what Dylan Howard will draw up for his Bulldog team. And we won't just be covering men's basketball, we'll be covering women's basketball, the Lady Bulldogs as well. Games happen back-to-back in SWAC play. Should be a fun year. Coach Margaret Richards going from 2-28 to 10-19. Now looking to build off of that and maybe have a deep SWAC tournament run.
Yeah, like I said last year, they were looking good. You know, I had predicted they would go to the SWAC tournament this year. So we're going to see if they can make it this year.
The player to watch out for, in my opinion, Ashlyn Dotson and Deshauna Harper. Those two names.
What you say? Watch out for who?
Ashlyn Dotson and Deshauna Harper.
Ashlyn Dotson, she's a great post player. You know, she led her team in scoring and rebounds. She was an excellent player.
So once again, ladies and gentlemen, we hope that you will be with us throughout the entire season, especially for SWAC play. Lady Bulldogs, the men's Bulldogs. Both teams looking really good, especially the Lady Bulldogs. I'm excited about this year. I want to go to the SWAC tournament.
We're going to make it there.
We're going to make it.
We're rooting.
And here we go at the free throw line. Number two, Jeremiah Bell. And Jeremiah Bell will – Jeremiah Bell misses the first free throw.
He makes the second free throw.
Makes the second free throw, though. Jeremiah Bell with the ball after the A&M miss. Here we go. And it's a foul called against, it looks like, A&M.
No, the ref kind of missed a traveling call on Jalen Reed right there. That's what the UAB bench was reacting about.
Well, Coach Ishin is very animated right now, and I think he has a right to be when you have such a good defensive team like UAB, you know, coming in here kind of expecting to maintain that defensive prowess that they had all season long and for the past couple years in the program. But A&M, they know how to fight, and every game's a fight no matter who you go up against. And let's see if A&M can respond after the layup to make it a 31-24 game for UAB. Down low to Sism, driving in the paint. Pull up, Jay, no good off the front iron. As Slovin brings the ball up the court. Over, wanted the three, was Bell. He'll pump, he'll step back over to Slovin, down in the low post. And the Senegal big man can't get it to go. That's Gouye with the hook attempt. No good. As A&M now has the possession once again.
Jones Jr. down. Number 22 with the huge dunk, and that's Garen Sism, the junior out of Huntsville. And it's now a 31-26 game.
Right, Reggie, that's how you be strong down low. Sism, he's a great player down low. You know, he's filling in that missing piece they had last year.
And let's see if A&M can maintain that pace on defense. Only a five-point game. Keep in mind, A&M is pretty undersized. They have one of the smallest teams, not only in the SWAC, but in the country. As UAB makes a corner three from the right corner to make it a 34-26 game. Nearly turned over. A&M maintains possession. Over. Three ball. Jones Jr. No good off the back iron. And UAB gets the rebound. And they now have the possession.
Great shot. Like I say, you got to knock the ball down. You got to.
I mean, A&M, they're not really a three-point shooting team. They only shoot around 29% from the three-point line. But you're right. If you're open and you have a chance to take it, you have to make it. That's the name of the game. If you take it, you got to make it. Here we go. Over. Another three ball, this time from Bell. No good off the left iron. But UAB gets the offensive rebound. And it looks like someone might be hurt. Oh, no. We couldn't really see the play that well from our vantage point. But I see a UAB player down. And he is in pain.
And also number 11.
Oh, three ball. Jones, no good off the back iron. And we can't see what's going on right now. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're just tuning in with us, Alabama A&M down 26-34, but on the last possession, a UAB Blazer went down underneath the basket. We don't know what happened. Couldn't really see it from our vantage point. But we hope that he is okay. And it looks like he is still down, but able to get back up on his feet.
Yeah, that's your guy. Number five.
Oh, yeah, the Senegal sensation. Maktar Gouye, I mean, he's a prowess right now. He's been the focal point for this UAB team. Outside of Brian and Bell, he's had a lot of emphasis in the game defensively. When you start out with three blocks in the first 5 minutes early, I mean, you've made your impact on this game already.
You're right.
He'll be escorted to the bench.
You're right, Red. And that's going to be a big missing piece that will be missing. You know, he plays a good part on the defensive side.
And ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. The Senegal sensation that we said, Maktar Gouye, is okay. He was able to stand under his power. He was able to get up under his own power. We're glad he's okay. He'll be on the bench right now taking a breather as A&M gets the ball back, down only by 8, 34-26 with just over 50 seconds to go in the game. And the ball is kicked out of bounds by number 21, Jalen Perry of the UAB Blazers.
No, Red, Jalen Reader, he's great at creating his own shots. Have you noticed, like, he creates his own shots?
Oh, yeah. I mean, he has a pull-up J. He has a three-point shot. He can stand still and make it. He can catch off the dribble. I mean, he can shoot off the dribble. He can shoot off the catch. He does it all on the offensive end for this A&M team. Not just him, but Arthur Johnson as well. But he's more of like a mid-range shot creator, in my opinion. The beautiful drive by Trey Tide. And he will go to the free throw line. The foul called on, I think, Will Butler, number 12. The 6'8 forward will be called on the foul as Trey Tide goes to the free throw line. Only down by 8 with just over 30 seconds to go in the first half. Here we go. First free throw attempt for Tide. It's up, and it's good. for Trey Todd. And here we go. He would be making a substitution. Tamel Pearson will come in for Will Butler. Trey Todd, second free throw attempt. Right now, Trey Todd is shooting 60% from the free throw line. And he goes 1-for-2 from the free throw line. And that's number 3, Tavin Loban, with the rebound. Let's see what Jeremiah Bell can do running the offense for the Blazers. Here we go. Moving the ball around, half-court circle. Trying to set up the offense, trying to waste clock. Smart ball, smart basketball, smart decision making. 10 seconds, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, driving. Three ball, pull up mid-range. No good by number 21, Jalen Perry. And that will be the first half. UAB leads it 34-27. Some key players for UAB, Tavin Loban, of course, Zach Bryan and Jeremiah Bell. And for A&M, Andre Candy, Jalen Reeder, and Arthur Johnson. So you think A&M played a really good first half?
Yeah, they screaming the band kind of loud, but they played an excellent half, you know. They made a better option, you know, playing defense on the defensive side, start moving the ball more, and getting open shots, you know, taking the best shot possible.
Well, I feel pretty good about the second half, and you show that. And if you show that you can fight at any point in the game, you can win at any point in the game. And I got to say, to be down by 7 to this kind of a team, to this really good defensive team, shows how good you are in your development of young talent. And I think Dylan Howard, he might make a statement on this program if he can get a big win tonight.
Like I said, A&M, they looking better defensively. You know, Trey Todd, he's a good defensive player, you know. He stood his ground. You know, they did a great job of limiting UAB Blazers from their shots.
Well, I got to say thank you once again, Alabama A&M, for showing us this, for having us on here commentating the game. A&M students here, camera working. Really fun night here in Huntsville, live at the Von Braun Center. Really excited about tonight's basketball game. And right now, 34-27, A&M down, but not out. End of the first half, and we'll see what happens in the second.
my dog, so that's my dog. Yeah. I'm on my way, I'm going fast. I'm coming home to get you home. I'm on my way, I'm going fast.
Companies hunger for our food scientists. Here, a new generation manages our cities of tomorrow. The discovery of hardier plants, healthier animals, is growing at our research station, Alabama A&M University, where new designs and ideas are put to the test. Be a researcher in our labs or a forestry fire dog in our fields. Alabama A&M University. Start here, go anywhere.
Ariel took down enough pins to help win a conference championship. Her mechanics are just as strong in engineering. Aiden is mastering psychology on the golf course and in the classroom. No hurdles too high for Raven, on the track or in nutrition. Alabama A&M, 4 years of artistic, academic, and athletic discovery. We deliver the full university experience. Alabama A&M University. Start here, go anywhere.
Hello, I'm Dwayne Green, Interim Director of the Office of Admissions. We're excited that you are here with us today, and because you are here, we know that each of you had other options, but you chose Alabama A&M to be your number one choice. For the next 3.5 minutes, this video will illustrate to you the journey of how we got here. It will also introduce to you our hardworking team and the roles they played over the last 10 months in getting you here today. Welcome to Alabama Agricultural and Mechanical University, and we hope you will enjoy.
here to make it a 34-20. Junior, no good off the back iron. Now have the possession. Rebound. Like he is still down, but able to get back up on it. The ball is kicked out of bounds by number.
Going shot. Have you noticed, like,
but he's more of like a mid-range shot creator, in my opinion. Drive by Trey Todd.
Great at creating his own shot. Have you noticed, like,
he can shoot off the dribble. He can shoot. And he will. Tamel Pearson will come in for Will Butler. Trey Todd, second free throw attempt. Right throw line, and that's number three, Tavin Loben. Throw line, and that's number three, Tavin Loben with. And ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Alabama A&M basketball. The maroon and white right now down by 7, 34-27. The Blazers lead live here at the Von Braun Center in beautiful downtown Huntsville, Alabama. And UAB bringing the ball off the floor, led by number two. That's Jeremiah Bell. Moving the ball around. Down low to Gouye, coming back in the game after a very tough-looking injury he sustained earlier in the first half, but he seems to be good to go for the second. And the tough shot put up and made by Tavin Loven. So, Josh, when you look at the first half and look at how tough A&M played, can the Bulldogs maintain this momentum?
Well, it's still going to be a fight. It's still going to be a fight to the finish, you know, Reggie. You know, Jalen Reed, he's having a great game, you know. But they have to knock down their open shots. See, just like when Arthur Johnson just missed, he had to hit that down to have a if they have a chance to win this game, excuse me.
Well, you're right about that. A&M right now not really making any sort of open shots at all. I mean, look at this A&M squad, averaging well around 29% from the three-point line. That's roughly 2 out of 10 per game if you take that on average. So we'll see if A&M can finally get the offense to click. Pull up, Jay, no good by Perry. That's number 21 out of UAB. The pull up mid-range is airballed, and that's a shot clock violation. A&M will get the possession back.
That was a great defense by Jalen Reeder. You know, he stayed with his man, you know, stayed to the finish.
Here we go. Let's see what A&M can do. That's number two, Brandon Miller. Back over to Johnson. Down in the post. Kennedy posting up. And it's a turnover on Jalen Reeder as number 21. That's Jalen Perry for UAB makes up for the missed, for the shot clock violation on the last possession. Tip pass, A&M, they have to maintain possession at the corner. Over, driving, jump shot, no good, off the iron. A&M maintains possession and gets the putback. That's Arthur Johnson on the putback chance, and it's now a 38-29 game. Here we go, moving the ball around, UAB down low. That's Sullivan, and he makes the easy low post shot, and it's now a 40-29 game. UAB slowly, slowly but surely increasing the lead, and it's another bad pass, this time from Andre Kennedy to Arthur Johnson, but the ball goes out of bounds, so A&M maintains possession.
A&M has to slow down before they let this game get out of hand, Reggie.
Well, you saw UAB, they transitioned to more of a double-team, half-court press situation. Could that get in A&M's head and cause them to have to struggle on offense?
Well, no, I wouldn't say that technically. You know, they still can fight around that, you know, just by great strategy and trying to push the ball up court. To overcome that press, you'll have to, you know, have help out backcourt, you know, trying to help get the ball cross court.
Well, at the free throw line is Jerron Sism, the 6'8", 210 junior, playing for the A&M Bulldogs, one of the 13 Alabama natives on this roster. Dylan Howard stayed close to home here in the state, making sure he got players from Alabama, players that were in their A&M's backyard, and he did that very successfully. Post up, turnaround, nearly stolen by A&M, and they get the turnover, forcing the steal. Here we go, transition, Reeder at the wing, over Sism, wants to drive, down Johnson, but it's picked, it's intercepted by number two, Jeremiah Bell. Bell intercepted the pass, but he's limping on the court right now. I don't know. He's walking, trying to walk it off.
Yeah, really, that was great hustle by Sism. You know, that was a great defensive play, but they had to score off a turnover like that.
Let's hope that he is okay. He was seen limping just now, and he'll be taken back to the locker room. Trying to walk it off. But they'll keep him out here just in case. Oh, I don't know. But let's get back to the game as Reeder drives. Coming off the screen. Sism down low. Jump shot is good in the paint. And it's now a 42-34 game for the UAB Blazers. A&M trying to decrease the gap. It's now just an 8-point lead. Here we go. Moving the ball around is number one, Zach Bryant. Here we go. At the corner. And Perry gets the foul call. And that's on number 10, Arthur Johnson.
While we have the break we got right now, Red, let's talk about the other SWAT team going around today.
Well, Texas Southern, they have a home game tonight. They will be at home hosting Houston Tillman, and Jackson State is on the road playing a 9 p.m. late West Coast game. They're out in California. They're taking on the University of Santa Clara. That is pretty interesting. Jackson State right now, they're 1-6 on the year. Texas Southern, 2-4. Other teams around the SWAC, Grambling, 3-3. Bama State, 2-4. UAB. Arkansas Pine Bluff, 2-5. Valley State, 2-6. Alcorn, 1-6. Prairie View, 1-6. And Southern sits at 1-6 as well. A&M, the only team in the SWAT, searching for that very crucial first victory. Oh, man. You know,
Santa Clara? I'm sorry, people. I'm sorry. That's a very interesting statistic. That's a very interesting fact to me. Santa Clara? I wonder who's scheduling their games. We need to get a game out in Santa Clara.
Sound like a great place to be.
Well, let's get back to A&M basketball here in the Von Braun Center. Neutral site game, but technically it's a home game for A&M. Just not on campus at Alabama A&M University on Normal Hill. Here we go. Zach Bryant, crossover between the legs. Ooh, trying to run the offense. Down to Will Butler. Over to Jalen Perry, top of the key, wants to drive. No foul call. Oh, it's a late whistle. And that will be called against number 10, Arthur Johnson. And he's looking like, where's the foul, ref? And I have to agree, where was the foul, ref? But regardless, it's a foul call against A&M, and the Blazers will go to the free throw line for another pair of free throws. And this UAB squad under head coach Robert Eschen, I mean, the legacy he has. He actually graduated from the University of Maryland, but he ended up becoming an assistant under Jared Haas. And in that system, he saw the winning culture at UAB. They go 26-7, best year they had in that tenure. 14 seed in the men's tournament, and they beat the number 3 seeded Iowa State Cyclones in a huge upset. So he has that way of instilling winning basketball in UAB's program. But on the other side of that, you have Dylan Howard, head coach of A&M right now, the interim head coach. And he also has some Maryland background. He was the assistant coach at Maryland Eastern Shore. And in his 5 years at Maryland Eastern Shore, 89 wins. So Dylan Howard is no slouch when it comes to having successful basketball teams under his wings.
You just used that word slouch, though.
Look,
we gonna speak.
I
on
say
that.
A different word a day, okay? Get but it. My favorite words are plethora, sometimes slouch.
Reg, it's okay to get in a little of that slang,
the
man.
The fundamentals. As UAB makes the layup, it's now 44-34. Gotta always have a little fun commentating games.
Yeah.
Here we go. Let's see what A&M can do now. Trey Todd with the basketball over. And that was Miller. Back to Todd. The three ball doesn't get the lucky bounce. And Maxar Gouye once again with the rebound. Here's an interesting fact for you. Maxar isn't the only person that's not from the United States on this roster. Luis Hurtado comes out of Venezuela. Will Butler out of Jamaica.
Wow.
That
shows UAB do a lot of recruiting outside the country.
And Jude Akabuize out of Nigeria. Wow. I mean, hey, they have the pipeline everywhere. So it's pretty contrasting. UAB, they like to recruit out of Alabama. A&M likes to recruit in Alabama. That's pretty interesting.
Well, Alabama is not, no, I wouldn't say, don't quote me on this. They're not technically a basketball state. So, you know, it's best to recruit outside the state. It's great players in Alabama, but, you know, majority of great basketball players come from up north. Most of the time, most.
Some pretty good players out of Alabama, just to name a few, Eric Bledsoe and DeMarcus Cousins.
Right.
Eric Bledsoe out of Bessemer, Alabama. DeMarcus Cousins out of Mobile, Alabama.
You're right.
So we got some representation in the league as a state. We got some representation, some good representation of that.
I'm just saying, like, as percentage-wise.
Yeah, percentage-wise, I can understand
that. No, it's a great Alabama player. You know, you have John Petty come from, you know, Huntsville, Alabama. Came from Jemison High School.
Huntsville native.
once was ranked in the country. You know, Josh Langford. You know, we got good players.
So, once again, Dylan Howard, do you think maybe he'll be promoted to the permanent head basketball coach, regardless of how the season turns out?
That's tough to say right now. You know, it depends how their season gonna end. You know, right now they look like a better Alabama A&M basketball team. They look better than last year. You know, but it's gonna be tough. It's gonna take two to three years worth of, you know, rebuilding.
Well, the wild pass there from Garen Sism, and his teammate couldn't hold on to the basketball. That was Brandon Miller who lost the handle. And UAB will get the ball right back in. You're right about that. I think as long as he proves that this team is developing, I think the people, the higher-ups at A&M, just might keep him around as the permanent head coach. And it's a turnover for UAB. Johnson, fast break chance. The alley-oop to Andre Kennedy. And that will be a foul, I think. Oh, I'm sorry. I think the ball just went out of bounds. The alley-oop chance. Hold on. I haven't seen this out of A&M. Last spring, I didn't see this out of A&M. I didn't see this. Okay. Wow.
Hold on now, Reg. I saw a lot. Andre Kennedy, he's a great player. You know, he's very athletic. You know, he caught a body last year. caught him one last year.
But speaking of Andre Kennedy, let's get back to him. So Andre Kennedy, he's one of the leaders of this team. And by that last possession, now the foul was called, and Kennedy is at the free throw line as we speak. So do you think A&M might go to a more up-tempo game come SWAC play, come SWAC conference champ, come SWAC games in the spring?
Well, I want to say up-tempo, you know. It's just – you know, maintain they play as of now, because you know they playing out of conference team, and everything gonna be different in the SWAC. You know, I think they're gonna have a great season for real, because they look good. You know, they playing a lot of out of conference team, so it's tough to tell now. They might have a good looking record than last year.
And I can see what you're saying about that, as Reeder puts up the three, but no good. Once again, missing open shots. I think that transition play right there is a small tidbit of what A&M could bring once they reach SWAC competition in January, February, and March. I think Dylan Howard might bring something different that the previous head coaches at A&M didn't have before, and that was that up-tempo pace that we're kind of looking for. And it's a foul called against UAB. And A&M will go to the free throw line. And there will be a timeout on the floor. Let's see if Robert Eschen can find a way to maintain this momentum. Or will head coach Dylan Howard, first-year head coach, find a way to bring A&M back into the game?
Yeah, you're right about the up-tempo pace they playing. You know, he's doing a great job of, you know, they coaching them, you know, teaching them how to facilitate the ball, move the ball around. You know, their defense got better. And, you know, they playing great, but they just got to get their first win.
Well, I think it's always tough when you're playing out-of-conference competition. I mean, for example, the ACC Big Ten Challenge right now in college basketball, you're playing a different, tough team every single, you know, day or every other day in that challenge, and it's going to always be tough at the beginning of the season when you're taking on out-of-conference competition. Those are teams that you don't see at all, at least for a year or two, compared to seeing teams every year in the SWAC and knowing what they can do and knowing what to expect. You don't know what to expect out of out-of-conference competition. And A&M, they're holding their own pretty well. They can still come back into this game. It's never over until it's over. They have 11:50 left in the second half. And I think they can find a way to claw back into it and maybe make it, you know, a pretty close contest.
Well, Reg, it's not impossible to beat an out-of-conference team. You know, they did it one year when Ladarius Cab was here. They beat Tulane. So, I mean, it's not impossible. It's just, you know, depends on the heart of the team and how much they want to win.
And Jeremiah Bell right now is running around for UAB, so that is a good sign. You always want to see players up and walking. You never want to see them be hurt. And it's always good to see players, you know, getting up after something that looks pretty rough on them. And at the free throw line right now for Alabama A&M is number zero, Jalen Reeder out of Kissimmee, Florida.
Yeah, going back to what you said about Bell, yeah, it looked like it was kind of his hamstring. You know, he was getting stressed out right here on the sideline. You know, he's trying to work on it, try to run around, try to get his feeling back.
Yeah, and it's always good to see a player walking around, and I think he should be okay now, but they're still going to keep him on the bench just as a safety precaution for right now. And let's see what UAB can do now. And into the game right now, that's number four, Anderson McCoy. This is his first time seeing some minutes on the floor for the Blazers at guard, but a fast break chance for A&M. Ends in a layup plus the foul call, and A&M will go to the free throw line for one more.
And that was a great defensive play by Andre Kennedy with a great block. You know, that's the tempo you're talking about. You know,
oh, yeah.
They got to score off them turnovers and make sure they make these shots.
And right now, if you can't make shots from the outside, you got to go inside. Arthur Johnson, he wasn't going to kick it out to a teammate from the three-point line. He knew they're kind of struggling, but he felt as if, okay, I got to get the ball in my hands. I got to go inside. I got to get the tough finish. I got to take the contact, and that's exactly what he did. And it's now a 9-point game, but UAB makes it an 11-point game once again. The beautiful layup by Lewis Sullivan, and it's now a 50-39 game.
Red, have you noticed, like, Dylan Howard, he's changed the defensive game this half. You know, they're playing more of a 3-2 half-court defense. You know, they're close to half-court. I think they should, you know, tighten up. You know, they're too far. The middle is wide open. So I think they should, you know, play the regular 3-2 instead of having all the way up to half court.
Well, Gary Sism seems to disagree. I mean, he got a huge block on the last possession, and A&M gets the ball right back. But, yeah, you're right about that. You gotta tighten up on defense. You said they're playing 3-2 right now. Should they go to more of a half-court press, maybe – I don't know. Or just go straight man-to-man in your face, one-on-one defense?
Yeah, that was the look, kind of like a half-court press. But, you know, I'd say they should go full-court press instead.
Full court.
Yeah. I mean, they're down in this game. As a nasty dunk by number one off of UAB, Zach Bryan, who came off a 26-point last game. You know, they have to, you know, play defense, you know. Tighten up the defense, run a full court press, because they're down in this game right now. They need to get back in this game.
And it's a timeout call for the UAB Blazers. UAB's up 52-41 right now. And I got to say, A&M, they can't let this game get away from them. They have to find a way to come back into it, but it's not over. There you see once again the A&M cheerleaders at the half court. And you can hear the march of maroon and white. And there you see some people in the crowd. Some maroon and white representation coming from the stands here at the Von Braun Center. We also see some Blazer gold and green. I'm a Birmingham native. Maybe he's very popular back at home. But here in Huntsville, it's all maroon and white from what we see, with some shades of green from Birmingham. And once again, we want to thank Alabama A&M for allowing us the chance to commentate, to broadcast, to report, to give press conferences on all things A&M athletics here in the communications department. We're very thankful to have this opportunity to do this for you all live streaming day in and day out.
Right, Reg. That's one thing I was saying about, you know, A&M being a great school. They allow us to have opportunities to, you know, pursue our job and careers, you know, get our feet wet, you know, to know what we're going to do later on in life.
Most definitely. Alabama A&M, start here, go anywhere. And let's get back to the action on the court. A&M in their white, red trim. UAB with gray and gold trim. Bringing the ball up the court. Number one, Zach Bryant. Been a pretty big focal point tonight. At the half court circle. Over to Sullivan. Screen set from Sullivan. Bell back, moving the ball around. Bryant once again gets it back. Playing tough defense. A&M the double team on Bryant. Over top of the key. Back. Bell. Tough defense from Trey Todd, but doesn't matter. Jeremiah Bell with the beautiful jump shot to make it a 55-41 game. And A&M, they play good defense, but UAB played better offense.
Yeah, and Bell looking back to normal after that pull-up jumper.
And the ball goes out of bounds. And that will be Alabama A&M possession. Jalen Reeder on the inbound. Here we go. Miller with the ball. Half court circle. Over Trey Todd. Back to Miller. Drives. Passes it back out. Todd drives. No foul, but we'll get the tough layup to go. 55-43 game. And A&M they now decrease the gap to 12. Here we go. Zach Bryant with the ball. Moving the ball around. Butler subbed into the game, and the ball goes out of bounds, but UAB maintains possession. And inbounding the ball for the Blazers, number one, Zach Bryant. We've been saying his name all night long. And in the first half, Zach Bryant, he hasn't really done much. I mean, he shot 0 for 4 from the field. I'm sorry about that. 0 for 1 from the three-point line. One rebound. He struggled in his 14 minutes of play. I mean, despite that, UAB is still playing good basketball without one of their best players. As number 23, Lewis Sullivan misses the wide-open three, and A&M is in transition. Trey Todd over. Three ball. No good by Sism. And UAB with the rebound. Bryant over. That's Bell, the guard. Top of the key, back. Left wing, left corner. Goyer is posting up. Three ball from the left wing off the front iron, and A&M with the rebound. Transition. Here we go. Over. Johnson. Three ball. Bang! From the left wing three. It's, I keep saying left wing, but they keep shooting from the left wing. Oh, my goodness.
Going back to what you said about Zach Bryant, I mean, he really hasn't need to go as hard as he went last game because, you know, his teammates are doing all the work this game. So he really doesn't have to do much.
A good all-around team effort. I agree. Good team basketball UAB is playing. Despite the lack of play from Zach Bryant, Johnson, he brought it down low to Kennedy, but the corner three is money for A&M. Trey Todd, the 5'11 guard with the beautiful corner three, and it's now a 49-57 game. Hold on, people. Down by eight. Lovin driving, no foul call, no charge for A&M. Doesn't matter. Lovin gets the layup to go, 59-49. Here we go. Can A&M close the gap just a little bit tighter? Screen set over to Sism. Trey Todd takes the screen, passing it around, down low. Sism gets the foul, and he'll be going to the free throw line for a pair. We have a timeout on the court. A&M down by 10 points, 49-59, with 6:32 to go in the second half.
So, Red, do you think the Alabama and the Bulldogs have a chance coming back this half?
6:32 is plenty of time. You're down by 10 to, as we emphasize, one of the best defensive teams in the country. You have a chance to have a major upset tonight.
because you're upsetting one of the best teams in the Conference USA and one of the more traditional mid-major D1 powers in all of college basketball. They need to get in gear, understand the position they're in, and realize what they can accomplish here tonight.
You said it right, Jalen. I meant Red. Sorry.
It's all good.
I keep thinking about Jalen, one of our other partners.
It's all right, ladies and gentlemen. Like I said, the three-man crew of Jalen Herford, Josh Bullard, and Reggie Reese will be back together again for basketball season. Jalen couldn't make it here tonight, but he will be back with us. SWAC play is almost here. Conference basketball is almost here. The most exciting time of the year for college basketball. I'm excited. Josh is excited. Jalen is excited. We're all pumped up and ready to go for January. And at the free throw line, number 22, Garen Sism out of Huntsville, Alabama, the 6'8 forward. Here we go. First attempt from the free throw line. And it is no good as he misses the first free throw. Garen Sism from the free throw line. Surprising miss. He's a 90% free throw shooter. 9 for 11 from the free throw line this year. And he misses the second. And once again, like you said before, you have to get points when you can. You have to make shots. You have to make free throws. That might be the killer for A&M tonight.
Yeah, you said it right, Red. I mean, Sism, he having a great game, you know, with 11 points. But, you know, free throws win game, and you know you need those in the game.
Exactly. It doesn't matter how big the deficit is. If you can get points at will, no matter what, especially from the free throw line, because those are easy buckets. That's you at the line. It's just you, nobody else. You have to make those if you want to stay in the game and win the game. So here's some other notes from around Normal Hill, Alabama, Huntsville, Alabama, for the Alabama A&M Bulldog athletic teams. Softball, Cassandra Brown is the newly named head coach for softball. I talked to Coach Manny Lara for the A&M baseball team. He feels really good about this season. He knows he has a lack of pitching on the staff because they're young pitchers, but he believes in his guys, and he knows he can coach them up to be great relievers and great closers, as well as great starting pitchers for the season ahead, and that's up in February for baseball season and softball season. So support your Bulldogs. Go Bulldogs. And we hope that they have great seasons. As the chase down block is ruled a foul, as Jaren Sism, it's a goaltend. I apologize. I'm so sorry. That was a goaltend on Sism. So, hey, good hustle. I can't knock that.
And you said, going back to what you said, Reg, you're right. Alabama A&M has had a lot of great, a lot of transition through the athletic department. You know, they're looking to better their athletic program, you know. And it looked like after the air ball, after Sism shot, but it looks like they're doing a great job this year. You know, all the programs doing better.
Oh, yeah. When you talk about A&M athletics, there's so many new faces this year. From football to softball, baseball, basketball. You know, A&M is having such a youth movement. As long as they continue to build year in and year out and know what they have, this youth movement could be it could be worth it for A&M athletics. And at the free throw line is Matar Gouye out of Senegal. That Senegal sensation at the free throw line. He makes his first free throw. And coming back into the game is Andre Kennedy as well as Jalen Reeder.
Sound kind of excited to say Senegal.
The Senegal sensation, the 6'10 center.
Gotta take a vacation there, man.
Cool. And the second free throw is money. And Lewis Sullivan will check into the game for the UAB Blazers, and let's see what A&M can do now. down 63-49, 14-point difference. Here we go. Back to Johnson. Here we go. From the right wing over. Screen set from Kennedy. Driving. Back out. Running the offense. Johnson, the three ball. No good. Off the iron. And Gravy gets the rebound. And bringing the ball up the floor is Anderson McCoy out of Indianapolis, Indiana. One of the few seniors on this UAB squad. McCoy running the offense. Over to Sullivan. Driving. And number 21, Jalen Perry, gets the tough finish at the rim. And it's now a 65-49 game. And here we go. Let's see if any of them can find a way to claw back into the contest. Miller moving the ball around. Over to Sism. At the right wing, mid-range. Trying to run the offense. You'll be playing really stingy defense. They can't get any shots off. Sism back over, and it's a bad pass on Sism and a turnover on the court for the Alabama A&M Bulldogs.
And Rez, that is the defense you was talking about in the first half. You know, UAB, they're showing that they're a top defensive team, and they limited A&M to shooting bad shots. You know, they're taking bad shots, and they're forcing bad shots and getting a lot of turnover and scoring off of it.
So here's some other notes from Alabama A&M Athletics. For the men and women athletic teams, for the men and women's basketball teams, SWAC play officially begins January 5th at Elmore Gymnasium against the Jackson State Tigers. And they play another game after that against the Grambling Tigers on January 7th. They start out SWAC play at home with quick games against JSU and Grambling State at Elmore Gymnasium on the campus of Alabama A&M. The January 5th game is at 4 p.m. with the women, and the January 7th game is at 5:30 p.m. with the women as well.
So looking forward to the next game. What's the game plan for the Alabama A&M Bulldogs for the next game?
I mean, it's a young season. There's still plenty of basketball to go. You play around 30 games worth of basketball. And, I mean, it's a young year. You have an interim head coach. You're going through a lot of transition. I mean, the only thing you can do is learn and figure out who you are. Take this year as a learning experience and use it for next year. Use it going in to conference play. Use it going into the offseason and just build. Because that's all you can do is build, build, and build. As Will Butler, number 12, gets the huge one-handed flush at the rim out of Jamaica, the 6'8 forward at 255.
Just filthy. He did not have to do that. He did not have to do that.
And it's another missed shot by Alabama A&M. But wait, A&M gets it right back, and they get the easy layup to go. And it's now a 67-51 game with just under 3 minutes to play in the second half. Here we go, over to McCoy, running the offense, trying to set it up. They told him to shoot, and he loses the handle on it, and A&M will get the possession right back as Arthur Johnson will inbound the basketball.
Yeah, McCoy was looking for a call, but he just lost the ball. He was looking for a call in there, you know. He just lost the handle.
Maybe a reach-in foul. I don't know.
Nah.
Here we go. A&M moving the ball around. Trey Todd down low, and it's a missed layup by A&M. I think that was Arthur Johnson who missed the layup. It could have been Andre Kennedy. We have a hard time seeing from our vantage point. I'm pretty sure that was Johnson. But, man, regardless, A&M, you got to make the easy buckets. You missed so many open shots here tonight. Make the easy buckets. Make the shots when they count.
Right, and that's been hurting them in this game tonight. They've been getting open shots, but they can't knock them down, just like the free throws. Y'all got to hit the free throws and the open shots.
y'all doing a great job being open, but you have to make them count. You have to make them count. And they need to do they need to do better on this than in their next game.
I mean, you've had chance after chance. At the end of the day, you know you're playing good basketball if your offense and your players are getting open looks. Not down the easy shots. Don't make it harder on yourself. Don't. But I gotta say though, A&M, they still play UAB pretty tough. A&M defensively, get this, they give up on average 82 points per game defensively. So you're holding UAB to 67 points, which is really great. But you have to complement offense to your defense. You can't have your defense do the entirety of the work and not score. You have to score at sometime.
Yeah, Red, and that's what I was saying. They was doing a better job on the defensive game, you know. They going better, you know, limiting less points, you know. So let's see if they'll maintain this the whole season.
And it's a beautiful shot. And the three-point shot is in for Jalen Reeder, and it's now a 67-54 game, 2 minutes to play. Hold on. A&M, they're going to that full-court defense, like you said. Here we go. Anderson McCoy turned over the ball in UAB's last possession. Driving is Perry. And here we go to defensive stop. Transition. Reeder. Layup. No good. Kennedy had the put back dunk right there, and he misses it. Johnson. Corner. Three. Bang for A&M with a minute 32 to go in the game. Hold on a second. 67-57 with a minute 27 to go in the game.
And right just then, they back within 10 points with the three after Arthur Johnson with the three.
I said this to Jalen a while back. 13 points in 30 seconds, Tracy McGrady. Anything is possible in basketball. I'm just saying.
Anything is possible, but, you know, you can't compare them to the great Tracy McGrady.
Still, it's worth it. Let's see if A&M can score right here. One more three. Johnson, no good. And that might have did it in for A&M. 67-57, UAB has the lead, and they're going to probably waste clock as Jeremiah Bell is slowly winding out the clock. Arthur Johnson missed a right corner three to potentially make it a 67-60 game in the final 60 seconds.
Right, Red. And anything happening in basketball, that would have been a historical moment to see. But, you know, it's not possible.
Kennedy gets the rebound. 24 seconds left. Three ball. Trey. Todd. No good. Now, that tells me right there, if they made those two threes, it could have been a 67-63 game. I think Dylan Howard's going to probably have to go back to the drawing board and tell his players, why can't we make open shots? We have to hit open shots. And I get UAB's a great defensive team percentage-wise, but tonight they did give up a lot of open looks in crucial moments. And it happened once again, but A&M could not take advantage of the lack of defense at certain points in time.
And just like you said, Ray, they did a great defensive job, you know, limiting them under 80 points. The game is a 10-point. They won by 10 points. So they did a great job on the defensive side. So I think they did a great job tonight.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we want to thank you for watching Alabama A&M basketball tonight. We're live here from the Von Braun Center. The UAB Blazers defeated the Alabama A&M Bulldogs 67-57. And the Blazers now fall to 0-7 on the year. I'm sorry, the Bulldogs fall to 0-7, but the Blazers improve to 5-2. A tough loss here for the Bulldogs tonight, but you held one of the best teams in the country historically to 67 points. And I got to say, you know, A&M, they're going to look at this, look at the tape, and try and come back from this defeat.
Right. You said it right, Red. They did a great job defensively. So it's just a learning experience. So they're just going to get better each game, you know, practice more, see what areas they need to work on, you know. So I think they'll get better as the season go on.
but I like Coach Howard. I like what he's doing with this team, and I got to say it's been a great year so far to see this team improve game by game. SWAC play is soon, January 5th against Jackson State and 7th against Grambling State. We hope to see you there. Thank you for watching this broadcast of A&M Basketball. We hope to see you soon. I'm Reggie Reese. This is Josh Bullard. And thank you for watching us commentate A&M Basketball. And we hope that you have a wonderful evening and a great night.
And see you in the spring.
In the spring. That was actually perfect.
Hello, I'm Dwayne Green, Interim Director of the Office of Admissions. We're excited that you are here with us today, and because you are here, we know that each of you had other options, but you chose Alabama A&M to be your number one choice. For the next 3.5 minutes, this video will illustrate to you the journey of how we got here. It will also introduce to you our hardworking team and the roles they played over the last 10 months in getting you here today. Welcome to Alabama Agricultural and Mechanical University, and we hope you will enjoy it.